Get ready for a back and hip flow. So we're going to target your back and your hips. This is Flow for Balance. My name is Lilibet. And let's get started in a position where we can go ahead and start to warm up the body. And then from there, we can go ahead and target our back and our hips. Starting on your back, go ahead and just have your feet hips width distance apart. Let your arms be at a 45 degree angle away from your body. Let's take three cleansing breaths to recalibrate your body. Nice deep inhale through the nose, exhaling through the mouth. As you're here, try to just relax your shoulders, maybe wiggle them a little bit. Let your shoulders just fall and relax and release them down. Perhaps open and close the mouth, jiggle the jaw to release any tension you might be holding in that area. And then while you're here, let's set an intention for this practice. Remember to keep your intention nice and simple, maybe a word, perhaps a phrase, a mantra that you can repeat to yourself as you practice today. Maybe it's something that you can relate to that is going on in your life right now. Maybe it's something that you need to keep in your mind and in your thoughts as you practice. Perhaps the word breathe to remind you to just breathe as you move and flow. Perhaps the phrase let go to release anything that's been bothering you, that has been going through your mind. Maybe the word relax. Maybe the word ease. Whatever it is, see if you can go ahead and connect the breath to the pose, to the intention, bringing your practice full circle for you. Inhaling and exhaling through the nose from now on, keeping your breath organic and natural. Bring your arms to a letter T position. Go ahead and take the legs, bring them up to a 90 degree angle. Taking a nice deep inhale. And then exhaling through the nose. Inhale, take the legs over to the right. And then exhale, leaving the legs there. Taking a deep inhale. And then on the exhale, take the legs back up to center. Try and maintain both shoulders on the floor. If you feel like your shoulder lifts up, that's your limitation of how far you're going to take your legs over to one side. Nice deep inhale. And then on the exhale, taking the legs to the opposite side. Take a deep inhale. And then exhale the legs up. Let's do that again. Inhale, take it over to the right. Exhale, where your legs are reaching their limit. Take a deep inhale. And then exhale, bring it back up. You'll feel your entire core working. By the core, we mean the abs and the spine. So front and back of the body, nice deep inhale. And then exhale, taking it over. Take a deep inhale. And then exhale. do that one more time each direction. So a nice deep inhale, and then exhale, take it over. We want to keep the knees and the hip points all in line with one another. You might have noticed that I took my knees and brought them down a little bit further. Nice deep inhale, and then exhale. Inhale, and then exhale, take it over. Take a deep inhale, and then exhale to center. Go ahead and wrap your arms around your knees. You can have opposite hand, opposite wrist, or opposite hand, opposite elbow. Flex all 10 toes. Your option is to stay perfectly still in this pose, or you can rock side to side. It's up to you. Make this your practice. Remember that in yoga, there's no such thing as a perfect pose, just your pose. And we're all at different chapters in our practice. So you may be at chapter 50, or 1, or 20, or 5. But we are all at different places, and we all make this our own practice, which is the beauty of yoga, right? Take a nice deep inhale. On the exhale, turn to whichever side you prefer. Deep inhale, and then exhale, push to a seated position. What I would like for you to do is to come into child's pose. So your big toes are together, your knees are apart. Reach for your arms forward. You're going to feel, this is going to be really great on your back. We're going to take a few more breaths here. This is also a wonderful hip opener. The more you widen the knees to be wider than your hip width or as wide as your mat, you'll notice that you can sink down a little further and your hips will start to loosen up. Take a nice deep inhale. Start to bring your hands in towards your knees, and on the exhale, push up. Now go ahead and bring your knees a little closer together. We're going to do a child's pose, plank flow. So go ahead and come on to the top of your mat. Come into a plank. You can do this on the knees if that's where you are. That's perfectly fine. Otherwise, lift up from the knees, take a nice deep inhale, and then exhale into your child's pose. Inhale, plank, and then exhale, child's pose. Inhale, and then exhale back. Inhale, plank. Exhale, take it back. Inhale, plank. Exhale, bring it back. Two more times like this. Inhale. Exhale. Last time, inhale. Exhale. Now bring your big toes together, open up again, and then sink down as far as you can, opening up the hips, allowing your body to come through. Take a nice deep inhale. On the exhale, walk your hands over to the right. Place your left hand on top of your right, and really sink down and start to feel that you are having a nice side stretch along the left side body.
Really enjoy this stretch. Connect the breath, the pose, and the intention here. Take a nice deep inhale, and on the exhale, start to walk the hands over to the left. Place your right hand on top of your left, and then sink down. This time, feel the stretch along the right side body. Take a nice deep inhale on the exhale, land back in the center. Last time sinking down into child's pose here. Take a deep inhale and then caterpillar yourself all the way to the top of your mat and come into Sphinx pose. Make sure that your elbows and your shoulders are right in line with one another. Press all 10 toenails into the mat. Your knees might come up, they might not. Really lift up nice and tall with the upper body. Start to feel this in the middle of your spine and the low back middle point of it. If you have any issues with sciatic nerve pain, this is awesome for you. Take a nice deep inhale. On the exhale, go ahead and take it down. Bring your hands right underneath your shoulders and then squeeze your elbows into your body. Take a nice deep inhale. Come up into a baby cobra. Release your hands. Really press all 10 toenails into the mat. Hold it here. Keep breathing. Don't hold your breath. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take a nice deep inhale. And then on the exhale, take it down. Go ahead and push all the way up onto your knees. Make sure that your hips are in line with your shoulders. Go ahead and guide your hands toward the corners of your mat for puppy pose, melting heart pose. And then let your forehead come all the way down. Feel your upper back stretching. Lengthen the breath, connect the breath, the pose, and the intention. Think about why you made it here to the mat today. Nice big inhale. Start to walk your hands underneath your shoulders. And on the exhale, push up. Go ahead and come into plank. Hold your plank. Nice deep inhale. And on the exhale, start to walk your feet toward your hands. And then give me a generous bend in your knees. You can grab opposite hand, opposite elbow. Let your head hang down if you'd like. You can also leave your hands hanging down. It's up to you. Try to see if you can get your chest right onto your thighs. If you want to, you can sway side to side in ragdoll pose. Release your hands, and on an inhale, start to roll all the way up to the top of your mat.
When you get to the top, let's go ahead and roll those shoulders back 3 times. Nice deep inhale, and then exhale, bring it back. Inhale all the way up, and then exhale back. One more time, inhale up, and then exhale back. Take your feet nice and wide at a 45 degree angle. I'm gonna turn around so you can see what I'm doing. So your toes would be off of your mat, outside at a 45 degree angle. Your heels are underneath your hips. Inhale the arms all the way up. On the exhale, you're gonna come down into that yogi squat, and we're gonna do a squat flow, and then you're gonna bring it all the way up. Inhale up, and then exhale, take it down.
Inhale up.
Exhale, take it down.
Inhale, bring it up.
Exhale, take it down.
Inhale, bring it up.
Exhale, take it down.
Inhale all the way up.
Exhale down. We're gonna do this one more time. Inhale all the way up. And this time on the exhale, take it all the way down. Stay right here. If you have trouble doing a yogi squat and your heels come up, you can always roll a yoga mat underneath your heels. You can also sit on top of 2 stacked yoga blocks. So holding right here, lengthen the spine. Try not to let your body form a C shape at the top. So I'm gonna turn sideways so you can see what that looks like. Come all the way down. Nice tall spine.
Take your hands, bring them down. I want you to take that left leg all the way to the back. Bring your knee down. We're gonna come into a lizard pose. Take your toes, aim them to the front, your right toes.
You can stay nice and tall on your hands. You can also go ahead and place some blocks underneath your forearms if you'd like. Or you can come all the way down onto your forearms.
It's up to you. Try and make this practice your own as best as you possibly can.
We won't be here that long.
Relax the face. We tend to clench the jaw when we feel like we're working really hard. Connect the breath to the pose, to the intention here. Take a nice deep inhale, bring your hands in. On the exhale, push up.
Take your toes again at that 45 degree angle. And then lift and open up that hip. So pressing that knee out. Give it a good stretch. Really feel the body releasing and opening up for you. And if you're not feeling that opening up and releasing right now, the more you practice, the more you'll feel that. That's why they call it a yoga practice, right? Not a yoga perfect. Okay. So release
You're gonna go ahead and bring that left leg all the way back into your yogi squat, into Malasana Garland pose. Lifting the spine up. Lengthening the breath, relaxing the face. Perhaps letting your hips go a little side to side. Take a nice deep inhale. On the exhale, bring the hands down. This time, take that right leg back. Place that knee down. And whatever you feel you would like to do on this side, go ahead and take those left toes, point them toward the top of your mat. If you need to have your blocks here, you can put your blocks. You can stay up tall, or you can come down onto your forearms. We are asymmetrical. You may find one side might be a little easier to do than the other. This is always a great place to think about your intention. Think about what brought you to the mat. Relaxing the face. Maybe closing the eyes if you need to or want to. Giving your body some time to get into the pose, and always practicing with compassion and kindness for yourself. Take a nice deep inhale, start to bring the hands in. On the exhale, push up. We're gonna take those toes, lift them up on an inhale. On the exhale, they're back to that 45 degree angle. And then turn toward that left knee, and then start to open up that hip. Now on the left side. So now that we've done both sides, try to figure out which side felt better. Which side was a little more difficult, a little tighter, a little looser and more limber. Take a nice deep inhale. Exhale, bring that hand down. Let's go ahead and lift the right knee and come back into Malasana Garland pose for the last time. Coming back to that 45 degree angle. Lifting up the spine. Opening up the knees with the elbows. Take a nice deep inhale, bring the hands down. And on the exhale, you're gonna go ahead and either jump or just walk back into plank, take it all the way down, or let's do a quick vinyasa here. Down dog, two breaths. Let's go ahead and come down onto our knees, crossing the back. Take the feet forward. Let's inhale the arms all the way up. And then on the exhale, what I want you to do is I want you to really lengthen the spine. So reach, 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 reach forward. And then allow for the body to come down. Take a deep inhale, looking at your toes. On the exhale, start to walk all the way back up. Let's go ahead and come into a half hero pose, bringing that right leg back. Inhale the arms all the way up, flexing the left toes, and exhale, go ahead and take it down to your level of comfort. Take a nice deep inhale, look towards your toes. On the exhale, go ahead and walk it back. Now let's go ahead and open up the legs right here and come into Skandasana. So you are in a nice side lunge with that right leg out to the side and your left leg is extended. So you want to go ahead, you can keep both hands down, you can come into half prayer or full prayer. It is up to you. Take a nice deep inhale. On the exhale, let's take it to the opposite side now. Skandasana, with your left leg bent and your right leg straight. Deep inhale, on the exhale, come into seated. Come into half hero here in the back of your mat. Flexing the right toes, inhale the arms all the way up to the top. And then on the exhale, coming down to your level of comfort. Take a deep inhale, look toward your toes, and on the exhale, come back up. Let's go ahead and come into cobbler's pose, bringing your feet together. So bringing your feet to your level of comfort here. So the more you bring your feet in, the more you're going to work the inner thighs, okay? So this is what we want to work in this practice. So nice, big, tall lift in the spine, and then push the knees down. Take a nice deep inhale. Stay right here for just a couple of breaths. On your next exhale, if you'd like, you can go ahead and walk your hands forward. Take a nice deep inhale. On the exhale, go ahead and walk it back. Bring your knees together. Now let's come into bridge pose so that we can work our back for one more time before we close our practice. If Feet are hips width distance apart, hands are by your side. Take a nice deep inhale. And then on the exhale, let's go ahead and push the hips up. Holding here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take a deep inhale, and then on the exhale, slowly coming down one vertebra at a time. Bringing your knees into your chest and rocking forward and back, kind of like a rocking chair. Go ahead and take our feet to the width and the edges of our mat. Take your arms out to a 45 degree angle. Let your knees fall in together and let's take 2 breaths here. If you have any back issues or you are currently suffering from any back pain, this is a marvelous pose for you to remain in while we do our Shavasana. Otherwise, you can go ahead and walk your feet all the way down the mat and we can go ahead and recalibrate our body one more time with our 3 cleansing breaths, inhaling through the nose and exhaling through the mouth. Before you do that, slowly shrug your shoulders away from your ears in whichever pose you have remained, and let's do our cleansing breaths. Breath to a natural breath flow, inhaling and exhaling through the nose. Try and keep your breath organic and natural. Becoming clear once again with your intention and your purpose of coming to the mat. Try to let go of your shoulders if you feel that you are lifting them up towards your ears. Maybe once again jiggle the jaw or open and close the mouth to release any tension or tightness that you might have in that area. Feel a sense of lightness lifting you up, providing you some stability and groundedness. Perhaps a sense of ease and calm, balance, focus. Thank you. deep inhale, bring our arms overhead for a full body stretch. On the exhale, take your arms down beside you in full relaxation. On an inhale, turn on to whichever side you would like. And then exhale, push yourself up to a seated position. Let's inhale the arms all the way up to the top. On an exhale, if you would like, you can twist your wrists on the way down to release any tension or tightness. Maybe even shake your hands at the bottom. Inhale the arms all the way up to the top. On the exhale, bringing your hands to heart center, thumbs to sternum. It has been my pleasure serving you. I hope that you feel a sense of peace and calm. The teacher, the light, the love, and the imperfections in me, honor, acknowledge, and accept the teacher, the light, the love, and the imperfections in you. Please go out there and spread your light and your joy. My name is Lily Vett. This has been Flow for Balance. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope that you continue to support me by subscribing to my channel, providing me feedback, liking, and sharing this class. Namaste. Until next time.